Hi everybody, welcome back to my channel. It's Paul Anthony Love, and today I have the fabulous and the most beautiful Melissa Martin.
Hey. I'm so excited to finally get to be produced
al fin.
By Paul Anthony.
Al fin, pues mira que trabajamos para que
tratamos.
Pero ya, se hizo.
Se dio.
Y mira qué bello el cabello, es un cabello, it's a tutorial about sexy hair, and it was so much fun doing it.
I know, and nobody can say this hair isn't sexy. Please Hello. Subscribe to Paul Anthony's channel. Everything he has to offer, you guys need to learn, and only coming from the very best.
And thank you for stopping by. Thank you for the thumbs up, the subscription, as she said. Mm-hmm. All her information I'm gonna have in the description box of social media. You guys need to follow her.
Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram at Meli Marti, arroba Meli Marti. Así que síganme a mí también.
Y gracias, gracias por visitarnos y los queremos.
¡Mua!
Un besote. Okay, guys, I'm gonna go in with this fabulous product. It's called the Texture Builder from Matrix. So what I'm doing here is creating texture and body. So lo más importante cuando vas a preparar un cabello y crear el cuerpo, hay que crear la textura. Mm-hmm. So voy a usar este producto.
Para que quede así como bien grande. ¿Verdad?
Bien grande. Espectacular. Okay, second product, volume fixer. I go after using the texture. Yes, this creates more of a memory when you're setting the hair with an iron, so it can last longer and have a better hold. So it's awesome to build it as well before you go in and use the iron. Okay, what I'm gonna use now, what I'm gonna do now, I'm gonna go in and create the texture in the waves with the iron. So I section the hair. So it's gonna be kind of basically the same throughout the whole hair, but I like to section it so we can grab and create more body and when you section it, you have more of an opportunity to get in there and build the body that you want and the hair to last longer as well. And I go close to the root because I want to build the body in the root. So it's important that when you do that, doesn't matter. Sometimes it depends what you want to create. Sometimes we don't go as high, but I do it because I want to bounce it and give me that body as we texture it later. Muy importante. Me encanta crear el cuerpo en la raíz. Por eso voy cerca de la raíz para crear el cuerpo y con suerte rizo o la onda tenga el cuerpo que estoy buscando. Quiero crear. Here I pull. And I go into the next section and do the same.
Cuando uno tiene la tenaza, ¿verdad? Está haciendo los rizos, ¿cuánto tiempo uno debe dejar la tenaza en el pelo para que no se le queme, se le caiga el pelo?
Muy buena pregunta. Mira, van a ver, cuando yo hago la onda, siempre dejo que yo toque aquí y voy viendo con el pelo se va calentando. Es como una indicación que ya lo puedo soltar. Uh-huh. Y te da como una, más o menos, la temperatura que estás buscando. Uh-huh. Que no sea muy caliente, que no estés quemando el pelo y que puedas, pues, soltar en el momento preciso y a la vez agarrar la onda.
¿Y por qué lo aguantas así?
Lo aguanto para que más o menos coge la memory, uh-huh. To create memory, poquito, porque también me gusta como jalar un poquito después que lo haga porque quiero que la onda vaya cayendo.
Como natural.
Natural, pero con cuerpo y que se mantenga el look.
Sí, yo he visto videos a gente que se quema el pelo y no era que uno se le caiga el pelo.
Sí, muy importante que uno pues esté más pendiente y viendo. Y más o menos, o sea, claro, son muchos años de trabajo.
Claro.
Y ya yo más o menos sé los segundos que quiero y sin hacerle daño al cabello. Pero muchas veces la gente pues se exceden o no se dan cuenta y se queman el pelo. Se queman ellos mismos o se queman el pelo también. Por eso tú ves aquí, yo estoy, tengo el dedito y estoy tocando y más o menos viendo el calor. Y ya más o menos, ya sé que ya lo puedo soltar y ya tiene más o menos el calor que yo busco.
So basically just holding it on the corner, right?
Yeah, holding it and touching it with your finger. It gives you an idea of when it's ready and when you can let it go and create the body that you're creating or you're looking for without burning the hair or yourself.
Techniques, people. It's all about techniques.
Yes. And sometimes, you know, a lot of people get anxious or they say, oh, I can't do it. It's too hard.
Yeah.
Everything with practice. I remember when I started my career, I remember I wanted to like immediately wanted to cut hair. Mm-hmm. And I knew as time went by that, okay, well, I could say better, I understood that I had to wait and be patient. And little by little, the more I learned, the more practice that I had, mm-hmm. I was understanding more the science of hair, you know. And
for people who would do this at home, what would you say is like the main trick for them to not burn their face or to burn their fingers or to burn anything around like the
you know
face
what,
or neck area when using an iron like that?
You know what happens a lot? And I've noticed that when people get burnt or even myself, mm-hmm. you have to be very cautious, first mm-hmm. of all. Second of all, you have to be very aware and you have to be alert of what you're doing. Sometimes our minds go to different places and we have to be more like on it, you know, more present.
So, en resumidas cuentas, don't text and do your hair at the same time.
Don't text and drive. Tiene que de verdad estar pendiente porque muchas veces estamos en la la land uh-huh. y muchas veces ocurren cuando nos quemamos o quemamos el cabello, es que estamos en otra cosa en nuestras mentes y no estamos pendientes a lo que estamos haciendo. Y es importante que estés pendiente porque tu cabello primero que nada es importante
claro.
y no quieres quemarte ni quemarte el cabello. So, tiene
sí,
que estar...
de nada sirve, es un pelo espectacular y con una quemada aquí en la quijada de la tenaza.
Y no era. Y tú sabes que lo que yo aprendí una vez que me quemé, estaba con una clienta y me dio una quema y ella me dijo, por antes, le agarras rápido, tomate. Yo, ¿tomate? ¿Y por qué tomate? Me dice, porque mi marido es chef, cocinero, y siempre cuando se quema, él va corriendo inmediatamente, busca un tomate y lo pone en la piel y yo te juro, yo lo hice, se me fue el dolor primero que nada. No se me quemó la piel. No sé lo que tiene el tomate. No sé si es el ácido del tomate que permite que la piel inmediatamente, no sé, se recupere. Es impresionante, pero pruébenlo en su casa.
Yo he escuchado de mantequilla. Yo he escuchado de otra aloe para las quemadas. Tomate.
Tomate.
Señores, no que se lo van a hacer espagueti.
Y no que vayan a la casa a quemarse para probarlo. Que no vayan para su casa a probarlo. Pero si alguna vez le pase... Coja un tomate inmediatamente y ponle en la piel. Y te digo,
basta. No, o sea, picas el tomate, o sea.
Pica tomate, abre tomate y ¡pum! A la piel.
Sí, porque sabes que la gente va a agarrar el tomate entero.
Sí, yo te digo que yo me di una quema que yo pensé que la piel se me iba a ver fea. Pero te juro que me ayudó. It was huge.
So, highly recommended.
Highly recommended. If you ever get burnt, grab a tomato immediately, open it, slice it, and use it for your skin. It's gonna help.
I've heard of butter, I've heard of aloe, I've heard of so many other things, but I've never heard of tomato.
And it was from a chef.
Uh-huh.
You know, so he knows because they work.
Who says you can't learn beauty tricks from the kitchen?
No.
El truco de todas las mujeres.
Las extensiones. So what I'm gonna go, I'm going to set this extension, same method that I did her hair. So it's gonna be all the same in the way I'm creating the wave with this one as well. I did with each and one of them. So it's the same technique, but I want you guys to see how I use it and how I do it with this one. So you get an idea what you can do with your extensions as well. If you're creating some look with your hair and the waves, and then I'll go back in and I'll show you guys other things.
And to all the men who are watching this, we're so sorry. It's all a lie.
Okay, now I'm going in with this product. It's called the Height Riser. What I love about it, when I use extensions, it creates an amazing body within the roots. So I just go in there and just powder it up a little bit. And then I just go in and creating a little body in the root. I backcomb it. Then I grab the first extension. Here we are. We're gonna pin it. And what I like when I backcomb it, it creates like a little bit more stronger hold. And it helps a lot for when you pull. It's awesome. Estoy poniendo el producto para crear el volumen y después vengo con la peinilla y hago un poquito de teasing, pero en la raíz, y me ayuda también a crear el cuerpo después cuando poner la extensión, y también ayuda a fijar las extensiones. I create like here, like a horseshoe division, because I want it, you know, to be on the crown when the hair falls on top of it to create more body. So when I go in, I did, you know, I create back comb a little bit here. Grab the extension. It's like a halo effect that I'm creating. Now I'm gonna go in here, because I still have a couple pieces left. And it allows me to go in a little close to her. Right here in her front area. And it just helps me, you know, create more body and more texture to the hair.
Just so people know, there's different types of extensions, right? Like there's these that are clips, but these are the easiest ones for people at home to use. Pero, there's different types, right?
Oh yeah, of course.
People can like sew them in and...
Sew them in, you can put them in individually. It all depends, you know, what's easier for you.
Yeah.
And what's faster and, you know. I like the clip-ons.
Yeah, these, o sea, los clips son lo más rápido en cuanto a las extensiones. Y también es lo más fácil para uno utilizar y aprender a usar en su casa. No te dañan el pelo tanto.
No, para nada.
Las puedes quitar y poner cuando te dé la gana.
Yes.
Más variedad de looks.
Totalmente.
Ahora, eso sí, ¿verdad que hay que lavarla, gente?
Sí, very important.
Se tratan como pelo.
Claro, totalmente.
It's really important that you take care of your hair extensions, because just like your hair.
And I have someone that I always, up. I say that as well, you know. You can use them for years, yeah. years. Yeah. But the important thing is that it's all about how you take care of them.
Yeah.
It's like your own hair. It's like if you take care of your hair, not only are you going to have healthy hair, but your hair is going to look phenomenal, you know?
So wash, condition, everything you do to your hair.
It's important.
You have to do the extensions.
Because
even like hair product, right? Like
oh my
if
God.
You use like leave-in conditioner.
Yes.
You also have to put it on the hair extensions.
Totally. I agree. And it only helps you, you know?
Makes the difference.
Makes the huge difference. Huge difference.
Again, guys watching at home, we're so sorry. But again, we're really bad.
Now I go in with
so
the iron.
It's the sorry, not sorry, right?
Yeah. Sorry. So what I do is I go in with the iron and I start like fluffing it up, touching it up in certain areas that I want to create more body, and I go in with the iron again.